everybody, welcome to Kokopo episode 5. It's been a pretty quiet week, except for the release of one major game that we'll talk about in a minute. But let's start with the usual. Cody, what have you been playing this week?
War Thunder.
War Thunder, so not this week. Blade and Soul was not on the main menu? All right, so tell me, what was so special about you picking up War Thunder again?
Okay, so there was actually two events going on. There was a Halloween event, which just ended, and there was also the two-year anniversary. So I did both events and complete both of them. The first event for Halloween was a race map. You have to duck and weave between rocks and valleys and shit. And it's pretty crazy. And it was kind of frustrating because you needed to win three times, have a podium finish. And we raced about six times, and it took us a little bit. I played with Alec. He actually did not get any podium finishes, I believe. Maybe one, I don't remember. Because the issue of that is, like, you start out in a line, and then it's a full burn to the finish line. And if someone hits you, like another player, because I think there's 16 people racing.
All right.
And if someone hits you, you die, and then you have to respawn, and you lose so much distance. And we had, since there's so much planes, like, starting at once, it just started turning into, like, the circus, and everyone's running each other and stuff. And, yeah, it was kind of frustrating, but I was, for some reason, I was able to start in first. So I had a huge lead on everyone. Did that three times. And then the two-year anniversary was just shoot down five planes, and that wasn't too hard.
All right. How often does the game have actually events going on?
Pretty often. I don't know if there's any events going on right now that you can get stuff, but there are some events that go on that give you, like, bonus points or bonus XP for certain planes, or lower cost for getting planes or something like that.
Yeah. So you've been playing this game ever since I think I got to meet you at university. So you've been playing it for a while now. How would you say that? I know that they updated it where there's ground vehicles too, correct? So now you're both in the air and on the ground. Now, I saw on Steam that there is this game called Heroes and Generals. It calls itself World War II MMO FPS. I don't know how MMO it is, because I tried to look up how many players you could play with, but it didn't actually mention that. War Thunder is, what is it, 64 players?
No, it's actually, I think it's 24.
Okay.
Depends. It actually really depends. I think, yeah, I'm pretty sure it's 24 for, like, a regular match.
All right, so on teams, 12 versus 12.
Yeah.
All right. And, for example, if there was...
Or maybe it's 32, actually, now that I think about it.
Well, like, if there's tanks in there as well, how many people, like, are tanks? How many people are air vehicles?
So how it works with that is they kind of switched it up is... We usually play arcade just because how fast the games are, and you can get, like, a lot of points and stuff. But so how they switch it up with the tanks is that if you're doing ground forces, and then you get a kill streak, and then you can use a bomber for a certain amount of time, which is kind of interesting. It's like if you kill three or four tanks, then you can start using your bombers that you have in service. It's a good idea, but I don't know, because we don't really play realistic or simulator battles, and that one has, like, there's a clear definition between ground forces and aircraft that you use in the game. You can start in the aircraft, or you can start on the ground. But in this one, it's in arcade mode, it's like you get a certain amount of kills, and then you can start using your planes.
All right.
And then, like, how it works is, like, okay, one person has a bomber, and then it lets the team know, hey, this guy's going to use a bomber. Click so-and-so button to escort, so you can fly a fighter with the bomber, so you can escort the bomber in.
That bomber thing reminds me of the Battlefield
1943. I remember that.
Yep. But to also come back to that Heroes and Generals, I haven't actually played that at all, but because I wanted to know the differences, Have you actually played any of that at all?
I did play for a while. Only issue is it doesn't have a whole lot of Asian servers, so I don't have connection issues. It's just like they do have Asian servers, but not as a lot. So it takes a while to get into a game. And part of that reason is like for whatever reason, everyone likes to pick Germany. So the Germans, like when you go into a game, it's a really high queue. So, but when you use Americans, it's a really fast queue, so you can get into the game pretty fast.
All right. Well, what's funny to me is that that game, if you watched a trailer for that Heroes and Generals, their tagline is like, "Wars are not won by tanks alone," which is obviously like a sneer to World of Tanks, right? So.
I haven't seen that, but I wouldn't say that tanks like can win the battle, but definitely because I noticed that like I primarily play tanks in the game. It's okay. It's not like the most realistic thing I ever played, but it's pretty fun. But I always get killed by a fighter with bombs on it all the
All right.
time.
How big are the maps? Because they say MMO, but I don't know how many players there are on each team.
Okay, so what they mean by MMO is how it goes is like the game, the map is a conquest map, and you're fighting in like sub maps within the conquest map. So it's like separate servers, and they do that because you can't have like it's really hard to run, especially a game like that, like with so many players in one map. So I don't know. I think it's 18 versus 18 or something like that, or 24 versus 24.
All right.
They are pretty big. The maps are really big. And then how it works is like if there's a general, they're the one who sets up the objectives. So it's kind of bigger than just that one game that's going on. So generals has like influence on multiple games instead of just one. So it's basically a conquest map, and the Germans and Americans fight each other to gain territory and stuff. And then I think each battle lasts up to 2 weeks, so whoever has the most territory wins.
Wow, 2 weeks, huh?
Yeah.
All right, but yeah, okay. But like I said, you've been playing that since I met you, so your definitely go-to game would be War Thunder, huh?
Yeah.
All right, so anything besides that? I think you said that there has been have been a update for Elite Dangerous.
Yeah, but I don't really know what it is, and I haven't put time to
All right.
it.
I saw on Game Trailers the other day, we were talking about this in Blade and Soul, that you were saying that for Final Fantasy XIV, an update will be released. And I think I actually saw, like, a trailer for that. Is
Yeah.
that correct? So that has been released currently. Is that
There is
correct?
there was a recent update that added a few new dungeons and a boss, and then there's a new update that's coming out next year, I think January. And that one's the most hype right now.
Okay, so that one was just a regular patch and not like an expansion thing that happens next year.
Yeah, I don't know what trailer you saw, so I couldn't tell.
Yeah, I don't know. There was snow and shit. I don't
Okay,
know.
so that if it's snow, then it's either the new, yeah, it's both of them in both
Okay.
patches. So I can't tell.
I mean, maybe, World of Warcraft did that where, before a big new expansion came out, they updated the game to where you already had like quests and stuff that kind of brought you into that next expansion, those starter quests. And maybe something like that, I don't know. I haven't played it, but I know that you were saying that you were kind of, wanting to get back into that. Though you've also been playing Blade and Soul, of course. What level are you there now?
I'm still 32.
Still 32. Okay, so you haven't played too much then for
Yeah,
that.
I've only been helping you guys out.
Yeah, true that. All right, so that will be it, huh? All right. Now, let's of course go to what I've been playing, and haven't actually been playing too much. I had of course a lot of projects and stuff going on, but Call of Duty was of course released, and I bought it. And what people actually have to realize now, and I didn't notice until like 10 minutes ago, is that actually Cody mentioned that he was not actually he bought the game as well, and he was not able to play the game because of a Japanese version. This sometimes happens where on Steam, I don't know, a version gets delayed for us because we live in Japan and they need like a Japanese translation. A lot of Ubisoft titles have that. And Call of Duty apparently has that too, though this is the first time that ever happened to me with a Call of Duty game. But ironically, I was actually able to play the very first day, maybe because it's early access? I don't know. Maybe because you pay for early access, you get your early access. I don't know. Actually, a friend of mine back in Holland, this is a girl, by the way, she's a big Call of Duty fan. She's actually, she does game design. And she actually bought an Xbox One for Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. And I don't know what happened, but I think like the servers were offline or something. Microsoft servers were offline for, I don't know, 4 hours or something on the day of early access. So she called customer service, like, what happens? And they were like, yeah, sorry, you know, they're offline, and we'll fix it as soon as possible. So then you can play it again tomorrow, but there will be no compensation. And she got really mad. And, you know, they said they could fucking good go kill themselves or something because you know, she paid for early access and then she wanted early access. I mean, if you promise early access, you know, promise. I mean, you know, it's technology, so I realize that with technology sometimes can always, you know, or there can be always something wrong with technology you can never predict. But I do realize that if you indeed promise something, you know, deliver that. And I guess maybe that was the case why I could play, you know. You pay extra money, which ironically I didn't, but that's besides the point, for early access, and maybe it's like, well, okay, sure, we'll give you this one day where everybody can play because you paid for it. I don't know, but yeah. So I've been playing it, and because I've been playing it for one day, and now the game actually locked up again, so I actually cannot play it. But
Yeah, it's just really frustrating. I know it comes out next week.
Oh, that's fine. That's fine.
The 12th.
Because actually, one of the reasons is why I want to actually get back to an older Let's Play that I'm doing, and that is actually the reason why is because of news that came out, which we will talk about in a sec. But let me talk a little bit of Call of Duty. So I haven't actually checked any of the reviews yet, because I kind of wanted to go blind in this because of all of the Call of Duties, that have been released so far since the big like Modern Warfare hype. This one was the one with the least pre-orders. So compared to Black Ops 2, this was pre-ordered 70% less, and compared to Ghosts, this was pre-ordered 40% or 30% less. For me, Ghosts was a real disappointment. It was of course like a new sort of like campaign started by those guys of Modern Warfare. Though I think the most important guys got fired or they quit or something a few years back. But pretty much the setting I thought was boring, characters were boring, very cliche everything. It kind of got to the point where, oh yeah, no, there's, you know, you there's that level with the sniper, there's a level in the desert, there's a level where you need to be silent or something, then there's a vehicle thing. Very, I don't know, you could count the cliche things that they used there. And even the underwater level, which was one thing where I thought, well, they could kind of freshen things up there, was actually very anticlimactic. But here, I've only been playing 3 missions, so I'm now on mission 4. But it's a ton of fun. I gotta say, the mission where I am now, actually, I don't really like. It is in like a facility, like a factory, and I actually never like those sort of levels. I really like urban combat. So that first opening level, which is the level from the E3 demo in Seoul, South Korea, it's actually very cool. And I actually really like the setting. A lot of my friends are actually skipping this Call of Duty because of that setting, because of like the futuristic stuff. They want that realistic setting of modern day wars.
I don't know if you can really argue that Call of Duty's realistic in any
Realistic.
aspect.
Yeah, true that. But you know, they that's all they know, pretty much. I, by the way, I realized while playing, and I said this in the Let's Play as well, that back when I bought the very first Call of Duty, and I really loved the series back then. I don't like it that much anymore, but the very first Call of Duty I absolutely loved. I was 12 when I fucking bought that, and now I'm 24. Like, it's been half my year. Call of Duty has played a role in my life, and thought that was kind of sad to realize that. Of course, like I said, Kevin Spacey also plays a role, as everybody knows. Very cool. One thing that's actually very cool, I think, is that they have these cutscenes, which are like, in CG, so all the characters are CG. But Kevin Spacey is actually, it's actually the real Kevin Spacey playing there. So he's interacting with these CG characters, which I think is kind of cool. I at first thought that, whoa, they made the CG Kevin Spacey really well. But if you look at the hair, and you compare it to the hair of the other CG characters, you can see actually that it's the real Kevin Spacey. So that was kind of cool to realize. But just all of the settings are really cool. The third level is absolutely insane, where you fight in Africa in this busy city. In like a, I won't spoil, but in a scene that reminded me of like The Matrix 2. Just very, very cool. And because of that whole new setting, it feels indeed a little bit different than a regular Call of Duty. I really liked Black Ops 2 actually as well. Also because of the different endings that you could get and actually had influence on who you killed or who you or where you went and if you were on time or not. And I wouldn't say that this is up until what I played now is as good as Black Ops 2, but definitely, definitely miles better than Ghosts. And the game indeed doesn't look very very bad. I thought that Ghost was actually very disappointing in terms of looks. It was of course still the same engine, and I don't actually know if they use a new engine for this. But it definitely looks better. I mean, it doesn't blow you away in any way, in any sense. But it's definitely not an ugly looking game. So yeah, that's pretty much it. I mean, I'm actually I'm pretty positive. Probably the multiplayer, I'm not gonna play a whole lot. I don't know. Like, I get my ass kicked so much in that multiplayer. It's insane. And when it comes to that, I am more of a Battlefield player where I like big epic battles where, choppers are flying over my ass and tanks are hovering and that sort of shit. That is the thing that I like. As opposed to this quick sort of thing where, I don't know, like where you pretty much kill somebody every, I don't know, 5 seconds, or you die every 5 seconds pretty much. So yeah, in terms of single player, I would definitely say it's good. But then again, I only played like or paid $38 for it. Call of Duty games are pretty notorious for being short, so paying $60 for just a single player campaign is a little mad. But there's a co-op campaign, or not campaign, there's a co-op mode, which is apparently the exact same thing that was in Modern Warfare 3, where basically waves of enemies come and they get stronger and stronger and stronger. I don't know. Fun, maybe. I probably won't play it too much though. One thing though that I thought was ridiculous was that the season pass was $40. I mean, it comes down to a point where you pay $100 to get the game and DLC. I mean, it's some bullshit. And I think it's, I don't remember how many, they actually mention how many DLC packs they're gonna give. I think it's four. I might be wrong though. It might be also be three. But basically $10 per thing, I guess. But then again, yeah, I don't know. And they'll probably actually offer them for $15 per DLC if you actually don't buy the season pass. But still, man, I was shocked. They're money hungry whores pretty much over there. But that's pretty much it. Yeah, like I said, I cannot play it actually now, so I'll be playing another game. But we'll talk about that in a bit. I actually wanted to talk a little bit about Call of Duty just in general, because what was the very first Call of Duty that you ever played?
I don't remember if it was a PC one or a Xbox one, the first Xbox.
Yeah, so you had the regular one for PC. I thought that one is absolutely excellent. I think that the expansion is even better. The expansion might actually be my favorite World War II game of all time. Just because I like the setting really much. I really, for some reason, I don't know, but I really like the Ardennes offensive in Belgium.
Yeah.
For some reason, that really kicks ass. That those are also actually my favorite episodes from Band of Brothers. Those two, I don't know. It's there's something very,
Is
very.
it close to home feeling or something?
Maybe. Well, actually, I mean, there are, of course, also the episodes that play in Holland, but of course, you know, the US, of course, lost that fight, so a little bit anticlimactic there. But I don't know, the Ardennes is just so, I don't know, it's so struggling, you know? They're all dug up in those foxholes. When they do like mortar barrages because of all the snow, it looks so spectacular and stuff. All the wood and the trees that snap off, I don't know. It might indeed be because of Band of Brothers. You know, there's that episode where you actually follow that medic. I don't know. It's great, and how they represent it in video games as well, and that's why I really love that. It's mostly also because not a whole lot of other games actually mention the Ardennes offensive. I mean, a lot of people complaints about, for example, the Brothers in Arms series, is that pretty much that campaign went all the way up to Holland, and then when they got pushed back, the very last scene of that game is where Baker says, "How do you feel about snow?" And he says that to some guy. I think he says it to Red, which of course, you know, means that the next game is going to be in the Ardennes. And then fucking Gearbox announced, I think, like fucking Brothers in Arms Furious 4, and people got mad as hell because they wanted the next Brothers in Arms game and not this Inglourious
Bullshit.
Bastards ripoff. I definitely was one of them. I was like, God damn it, where's my fucking Brothers in Arms
Yeah.
game? So yeah, you had that PC version, but there was indeed also a Xbox version. It was called Finest Hour. It kind of did the same thing, but a little different. The looks were different, but it tried the same sort of levels. I mean, it had the Stalingrad assault.
Yeah, I really liked that one.
The
That was
setup was a little
actually,
different, but you know.
that was probably my favorite level because I had it for the Xbox, and that was probably my favorite level was the first one.
A game I have never played. I've played literally, I think, every Call of Duty game except for one, and that is also for the regular Xbox, and that is a game called Call of Duty 2 Big Red One.
Yeah, I remember that one too.
So that's the one that I've actually never played, and a lot of people, I actually have a regular Call of Duty Let's Play on my channel. I completed it, and a lot of people actually wanted me to play the Big Red one. They say actually that they really love that one. It's ironically, like I said, it's the one that I've never played. If I'm going to do that though, with an emulator, of course, I should probably do that before I play the regular Call of Duty 2 again, because of course, Call of Duty 2 already looks a lot better. But just to come quickly back to the first Call of Duty. So what was really cool there, of course, is that most shooters, you know, Medal of Honor and stuff, you were always fighting alone, and their whole setup was different, where they actually had to fight alongside a lot of people. And nowadays in Call of Duty, you usually fight with like 3 to 4 guys in a squad. But back then, of course, it was like big armies, right? Though the English campaign was kind of, I don't know, spying stuff, where only with a small group. But indeed, like the Russian campaign, you were with like all like. Not necessarily hundreds, but I don't know, 40, 50 guys. It
Yeah.
felt epic. I mean, the US campaign also had some cool stuff in Normandy, where you were assaulting that, right?
Were you assaulting in Normandy in
Well, not like the beaches, but you were in the droppings, like in the parachute.
what Call of Duty?
The first one.
I don't remember though. Maybe for PC, I don't remember.
Oh, maybe it's indeed not different for the Xbox version, but basically the first two missions are on the night, where they do the parachute droppings, or where they do the air drops. But you played both Finest Hour and Big Red 2 or whatever it's called.
Big Red Run, yeah.
How was that
I
like?
like that one. It was pretty cool. I really liked it.
That one had a D-Day level, right? An Omaha Beach level? Is that correct?
No, that it had it was the assault on what was it when they first invaded Italy? Because it mainly took place in Italy for the U.S.
What's it called? Operation Husky?
I can't remember, to
That's
be
like the
honest.
only operation that I know because of
Maybe, yeah.
Battlefield.
It was probably in support of it. I remember playing online, and I loved being the Italians.
Oh.
Yeah, they had pretty cool machine guns and bolt actions.
Okay. What about after that? Did you play Call of Duty 2?
Yeah, I had to. I really liked it. I was really good online.
Two, I think two was also indeed very excellent. At that time, they didn't have so much focus on the multiplayer yet, though. That, of course, came with Call of Duty 4. Have you ever played Call of Duty 3?
Yep, I had three as well.
So,
That one was pretty fun.
well, ironically, I didn't like the campaign too much. There were so many characters, and some of them felt a little
Yeah,
weird,
I
where
know so many.
you had, like,
You were the
Polish and
Polish, the
stuff, yeah.
Canadian,
I was
Canadian
like, I don't
person.
know who I'm fighting with, all these side characters, because there were so many I didn't care about. So that was a little underwhelming. But the multiplayer, though, had vehicles. I don't know if you
Yeah,
remember that. And that was very cool,
there's
I
the
thought.
tanks,
Yep.
and
I
then
thought that was
there's
very cool.
the little the motorcycles with the sidecars on them, and then they
Yep.
had the jeeps.
So that was one thing that I actually really liked about that. But yeah, like I said, in terms of campaigns, it was very underwhelming. It of course never came out for PC. It was actually a console only. It was made by a completely different team. It might
Yeah,
have actually been
Treyarch.
Treyarch, right? Yeah, that's
Yeah.
their first one, first entry
I
there.
remember the ragdolls were so extreme in that game.
Were they? I don't remember
Yeah.
that.
You like you just like pop a headshot on someone and they would like ragdoll.
Nice. The game actually also came out for the fucking Wii, which is
Oh
weird.
yeah, I remember that.
There's a scene where you cross this canal in the boats, and I remember that if you were at the Wii version, you had to, like, fucking do the rowing motion with the controller, which was kind of like meh.
The graphics on that were shitty.
Were they?
Yeah, I heard they were.
All right. Okay, so that's Call of Duty. It's a quick sort of thing. Then, of course, big one, and according to a lot of people, best Call of Duty in the franchise, the very first Modern Warfare. Did you play that?
Yep, four.
How do you like that?
I would say after four is when I stopped like playing Call of Duty competitively. I was really, really good at Call of Duty 4, and we were, I don't remember what the sponsor was, but at this time, at one point, I had a team that was like just mainly of online people, and we were sponsored. And then the only thing I ever did competitively was a GameStop posted a tournament, and I got into the semifinals, and I don't know what I placed overall. I think I placed like eighth, maybe. I'm not too sure. I don't know how many people were in the finals. I don't think there's a whole lot, but it went from it was Call of Duty 4 in the semifinals, and I completely wrecked. It was to the point where I was just using pistols the whole time just for entertainment because I felt like if I used a rifle or anything else, it would just be unfair for the other person. And people were like, "Why are you doing that?" And I had to explain it because it was humiliating the other player. And then I got my first round in the finals. Now between there was Call of Duties that came out in between 4 and Modern Warfare 2. So the issue I had is they tweaked the game engine a bit between them. So it was like, yeah, you had to get used to it again. And the dude who I versed actually had the game 2 weeks before it came out, and I got destroyed. Just because there was so much new stuff that dude was aware of, and like I didn't know any of the fucking maps, and I was like, so like didn't know what was going on at all, and picked I don't know if you played on Call of Duty 2. Do you know the map? I know it's you know the map on like 4 and Modern Warfare 2 called Overgrowth. Well, that's a remake of a Call of Duty 2 map. I forget what it was called, but we're basically
Isn't it a Call of Duty one? Is that the one in the open field?
yeah, it was an open field next to that little farm. And then there was like the hedges and the tunnels in the middle. It was a remake of that, and I knew the map, but it was really different compared to the one I was used to. I got destroyed. So I guess I was supposed to come back because I was that night. I didn't even get the game. It was a school night, and I was in high school when Modern Warfare 2 came out. And actually, I left, and they ended up calling me back because someone did tell the judges that the dude had the game before it came out. So either he was disqualified or they said that I would be able to go back into the finals and go against another person who never played the game before. And I didn't know that. So I was like, I never went back.
Oh, wow, okay.
Kind of sucked.
Yeah.
But yeah, after that, I started getting bored of Call of Duty.
Well, I mean, the first one after that was, of course, World at War, right? Did you play that?
Yeah, I did play that, and I was really into it. I was really good at it too. And then I actually forgot about that one, because there's Treyarch, so I was thinking of Infinity Ward. But actually, I'd probably say after World at War, I kind of stopped playing Call of Duty. I did have Modern Warfare 2, but I didn't play it online because I think Battlefield 3 was out that time, and I prefer Battlefield 3 more than Call of Duty.
Yeah, one thing, of course, also that starts to happen is that they still use the same freaking engine since Call of Duty 4, and I mean the games started to look really dated, and they still did some tricks now and then, where with Modern Warfare 2 they had some level at night where they had some nice lighting. But in terms of campaign, I actually really still liked the Modern Warfare 2 campaign. Mostly because there, they actually started. It might have actually been World of War that they started that with 2. But even more so in Modern Warfare 2, where they actually started to really hop from location to location very rapidly. So where, of course, in the old Call of Duties, you had the British campaign, Russian campaign, American campaign, all in different locations. You had to play them chronologically, so you were always fighting, for example, in Normandy, and after that, all the way in Africa, and then Russia or whatever. And in World of War, they did switch, but of course, it was always just Europe and then the Pacific. But in Modern Warfare 2, you had all these different locations. You know, you had the, I don't know, fucking Antarctica or something, Brazil, you had some deserts. Some European stuff, I don't know, but basically all these different locations that kind of made it varied. I really liked it actually fighting in the suburban neighborhoods of the US. Mostly also because those levels were a bit more open, and I kind of liked that feeling of fighting in those houses and just making havoc and fucking taking cover behind couch and everything. There's actually also in the very first level of Advanced Warfare where you're fighting in Seoul in South Korea. There's a section in there too where you're fighting in this big sort of like row or street of restaurants, and you basically go from restaurant to restaurant, and it's actually very cool because all the shit is just flying around. But yeah, I really loved Modern Warfare 2. Back on the PC, not a lot of my friends actually play on PC, so I didn't play any of the Call of Duty games very much online. But Modern Warfare 2 was actually the very first Call of Duty that I started playing a lot online. Of course, a lot of people preferred Call of Duty 4 because there you had, I think, an airstrike and a chopper, and that was pretty much it. Where, of course, with Modern Warfare 2, it became kind of ridiculous how much shit you suddenly were getting. With all the kill streaks and perks and whatever the fuck they added. I don't know. I mean, you had that thing where, of course, you had the nuke at the end.
Yeah, Jesus. 25 kill streak.
And yeah, pretty much that. I mean, I played it for a while, but then after that, of course, Black Ops came. Have you played Black Ops?
Yeah, I had Black Ops. I didn't play as much. I
Yeah.
probably played like local games more than I did fucking.
Are you a fan of zombies? The zombie mode?
Yeah, I like the zombie mode. I played it quite a few times. That's probably I probably played zombies more than I did the actual online.
Yeah. I actually know a few people that actually prefer the zombies so much that that is why they prefer the Treyarch games, purely because of zombies. So yeah, I guess that's a real sort of like cash thing, a cash cow for them. So okay, so that was Black Ops. I like Black Ops, but I felt that it was a step back when it comes to campaign from Modern Warfare 2 because Modern Warfare 2 actually had a few levels that were actually quite open, and Black Ops was very restricted again, very very linear. I mean, Call of Duty games are always, of course, pretty linear, but I don't actually remember if you remember Call of Duty 2 actually has a level on the US campaign where you have multiple objectives at once. And you can do them in whatever order you want. And that was actually pretty fucking cool. where it actually got started to open up, and maybe even Call of Duty 2 had that as, or Modern Warfare 2 had that as well. I don't think so though. I could be wrong. But yeah, Black Ops, I thought the first one, though I kind of liked it, felt like a step back into that. Then after that, we got Modern Warfare 3. Did you play that?
Is that the one when Soap died? I don't even remember, man.
Is that the one? I think so,
think I
because Ghost dies in two. In
yeah,
two.
yeah, okay, yeah. Did I play it online, really? No.
No. I mean, same thing again. I mean, the by the way, by this time the game really didn't impress me graphically anymore. The first level I thought was still very cool in New York. I thought that was kind of fun. Because that is still that is a reason why I really like Call of Duty and what it started me out with these epic battles with hundreds of units and stuff and shit exploding everywhere. And though they still have that nowadays, usually, like I said, many of the Call of Duty games now really focus on you fighting only with, I don't know, two or three other characters. And I won that big battle again. I mean, that in Modern Warfare 2, where you're in Washington. And there is, I think, that scene where you're actually assaulting the White House. I think. Are you assaulting the White House? I don't know. You're assaulting some political building. And it reminded me of just Call of Duty 1, where all these mortars and artillery barrages and all these soldiers attacking. That was very cool. And that's what I want. And it was also one of the reasons why Ghost, why I hated Ghost for that, because Ghost was all like, I don't know, fucking post-apocalyptic, we don't have an army, we cannot pay for it, bullshit.
Advanced fish AI.
But, what were we talking about again? Modern Warfare 3. Yeah, so the New York level I thought was cool. The Berlin level I thought was cool because that reminded me of D-Day where you were actually assaulting a beach. Oh yeah, you had of course the Paris level that was also cool. It was okay, I thought. I had some fun with some of the levels, but all in all, it didn't really impress me all that much. Yeah, I mean even the final battle, not too impressive. So that was pretty much the end of the Modern Warfare era, and then we of course got Black Ops 2. And like I said, for me, Black Ops 2 was actually a very big highlight in a long time in the Call of Duty franchise. Have you played actually Black Ops 2?
No, I didn't actually.
Okay, so I really like the setting. It's like 2030 something, and the game really doesn't take itself too serious. There's in the earlier level, there's a flashback level where I think you're in Afghanistan and you're riding on the horses and stuff, and there's this tank, I think the Russian tank, and it has two barrels.
Is it a anti-aircraft tank?
I don't know, but it like it's a regular like the regular what did I say, the two, how do you call it? Now I actually forgot, I'm blanking on the English word for it. Two, like
Barrel.
the big guns. Yeah, two barrels. So where the regular barrel is in the front, it now it just has two pointing
Yeah,
forward.
I'm pretty sure it's a anti-aircraft tank.
All right, they're using it as a regular tank though in the in the game, but like I said, it's not taking itself too serious. But what's really cool is indeed the different endings, and also that sometimes the consequence of your actions are not as cliché as you would think. So I was actually kind of like the good guy, not executing some people when I had the chance. I mean, Call of Duty is known for having some pretty gruesome scenes in, the airport scene. There have been some scenes where you can shoot unarmed or soldiers that have surrendered, putting their hands up. And so I actually decided to not execute some people, but just to like arrest them. And it had some horrible, horrible consequences. They got some pretty cool people killed. And not only that, in terms of like influencing the ending, you really have also influence on how certain characters look. So there's this boat chase, and if you sh if you do not shoot a certain like gas tank on time. The game does give you a heads up though, like, oh, you should shoot that. But if you don't do it on time, your side character that's with you all the time actually gets burned, and he has like this scar all across his face that he will actually keep all the way throughout the game. So that was something that I thought was really cool, where you really have influence, and the endings are also very different. I actually really really hated how in a lot of games they say, oh yeah, no, we have multiple endings, and the endings are actually not that different. That's kind of lame, but here definitely different. Not only that, you also have some different like levels, ending levels, if it comes to that. So Black Ops 2 definitely is a recommendation if you ever want to go back to and check out a Call of Duty. And then of course after that, the disaster of Ghost happened. Did you play Ghost?
Nope.
Yeah, don't. that's all I can say. It's not fun. There's not one level that I can say, oh my god, that's really stuck with me. I mean, like I said, the underwater level is actually something that I kind of looked forward to. Very underwhelming. The whole thing with, oh yeah, you can play with a dog. Very underwhelming, and also in like only two levels or something. Fucking boring. Like I said, I'm having fun with Advanced Warfare right now. But if you were indeed like saying, yeah, I was kind of done with the Call of Duty, yeah, man, it's you wouldn't get back in. Like I said, that level that reminded me of The Matrix 2. In Africa, very cool. I had a blast, but very, very quick time event heavy. So you actually don't do anything yourself except like press E now. If you don't press E now, you'll die, you know. And okay, I actually managed to fuck that up a few times, but you know the game just resets you, and basically you are actually not in control a whole lot. But it does still look spectacular. So that's pretty much it. I mean, yeah, like Call of Duty, I'm not really the biggest fan anymore, but it gets a lot of views. You know, my target audience, or my main audience, is mostly 14-year-olds. And ironically, those are the type of
people. They're like, fuck that, yeah!
Yeah, those are the people that play Call of Duty. I mean, I was 12 when, like I said, when I started playing Call of Duty, the first one. But it wasn't as brutal and gory as it is now. But yeah, no, that was pretty much the Call of Duty talk that I wanted to do. And now I kind of want to do some quick news about what I, like I said, because I'm actually going to do now then a different Let's Play that I've been wanting to continue for a while now, especially after hearing some news. And I'm talking about GTA 4. And I actually have a
5?
No, for the Let's Play that I'm doing, I'm talking about 4. But let me explain. Really? Yeah, so I have a Let's Play going on my channel. But unfortunately, it's been on a hiatus for a while because some other projects or some other games came out, and I kind of forgot to do GTA. It's actually being watched very good. The very first episode has like 1,500 views. But the twist is that I downloaded a first-person mod for it. So I'm playing through the whole game, and I also have a graphics mod, which makes the graphics look way better. But I'm playing the whole game first-person. Actually, the reason why I played it was I let the viewers decide what game I would play next, and they decided GTA 4. This was back in, I don't know, this was like 3 months ago. And so I'm playing through the whole game first person, but everything is first person. So if you actually get into a car, you see your hands and the steering wheel, and it's like you're playing a racing game. If you're on a bike, you see that and stuff. If you hold a gun, it's like a first-person shooter where you actually see your arm and stuff. But it is a mod, so it doesn't work perfectly. Basically, what he did was he set the camera right at where Nico's eyes are. So, for example, if you're actually wearing a helmet or stuff, it will fuck with your rear vision. Or if you actually wear sunglasses, your screen will actually get very weird. But other than that, it's very cool. And so why do I want to continue this now? Next week, is it next week? I think so. No, actually in 2 weeks, GTA 5 comes out for PlayStation 4 and Xbox One, and it has been announced that there will be a full working first-person mode in that game.
Yeah.
And I thought, God damn it, There goes my shtick. There go because I was already talking about in the Let's Play about, oh yeah, I cannot wait for GTA 5 to come out for PC, and then somebody will probably mod it as well to where it's first person, and of course GTA 5 is much better in graphics than GTA 4, and I cannot wait to play that first person. And it's like, well, they already made it. Okay, well, there goes my unique thing. Probably a lot of other YouTubers will now do that. But I checked the trailer and I was actually really impressed. Like I said,
Oh
it is
yeah,
a
true.
mod that I'm playing right now, and like I said, it has some issues, all right? It is very, very excellent what the guy did, and I give him all the props for making that mod. But for example, with this version, the GTA 5, you have iron sights right now. The game doesn't move very weirdly when you run around with your arms dangling and stuff. Getting into the car is excellent because, of course, GTA 4 is not made for first person. Some of the cars that have, for example, ornaments on the hood, if you actually play in a first person mode, you get one of those cars, you cannot see shit because the ornament is in front of your face, which makes it pretty much impossible to play. But no, it just looks excellent, very smooth, both with cars, motorcycles, aircraft. I think it's such a cool addition because it makes you feel so much more alive in that world, you know. I think it's so cool of GTA where all the NPCs are doing something, right? They're eating a burger or they're on the phone, listening to music, whatever the fuck. They're doing something, right? In Saints Row, actually, they still have a long way to go. I think GTA definitely does that well. Have you actually played GTA 5? What's the story there?
I did a few times because someone here had it. They had back when the dude, the Chinese dude Yuan, used to live here. He had a PS4, so and then someone else had Grand Theft Auto 5. So I did play it and check it out a little bit. It feels way different than 4,
Oh,
so I
yes.
had to get used to it. But I didn't really play it a whole lot.
Oh, yes. I think it's absolutely amazing. I actually have it for PlayStation 3, but I stopped playing it at. I was about 34% in, so I was one third of the way, and I stopped playing because I knew it was announced for PC, and I knew I wanted to do a Let's Play of this. So, definitely when a game comes out, and unfortunately for us PC owners, the game comes out in January, but I'm definitely getting that, and I'm definitely
Yeah,
going to play
same.
it. Also, of course, multiplayer, way enhanced, where. In the regular Xbox 360 and PlayStation 3 version, you can play all the multiplayer stuff with up to 16 players, and the next gen version, you can do it with 32 players. So you can do races with 32 players, but also deathmatch with 32 players, or just, free roam with 32 players. And there are amazing Let's Plays out there on YouTube, especially just Rooster Teeth, where you've of course the game maker now as well, where you can create your own sort of things. And I've seen these crazy races where they're on bikes and they're riding over the barricade or the side of a bridge, like all the way up to the top, and they're falling off like fucking, I don't know, rag dolls. But also, people are creating their own heists, of course. A big thing of the game is the heist system, and this still has not been implemented in the multiplayer mode. Payday is probably very happy because of that. But people are creating their own scenarios, their own heists, and just the amount of detail that game has is incredible. I mean, that is still, I think, the most expensive game ever created. I know that people say that Destiny costs 500 million, which is not entirely true because they actually have 500 million for that whole 10-year plan that they're doing. The actual game didn't cost 500 million. But GTA 5 cost 200 million, and just every detail, even when you leave the city and go into like that open nature, there's so many details there with so many animals, backpackers, hunters, just all sorts of cool stuff. And I love that game to death. And like I said, I stopped playing it, but I cannot wait for that game to come out and spend lots and lots of hours with that. What did you play though? Did you just play some single player? Did you play multiplayer actually?
For Grand Theft Auto? Yeah, I did once. I was at a friend's house and I was helping him move. And he's like, "You want to play some online?" So I'm like, "Yeah, sure." And just mess around and ran over people and shit. And that was it.
Exactly. Yeah. very cool. I mean, of course, also in the next gen version, we get all the free content updates with new cars and clothes and that sort of stuff. So that's also very cool. So yeah, no, I just I cannot wait. I'm very very excited for that.
I am too. Hopefully, I get that refund from Call of Duty.
Mm-hmm. Indeed. Okay. I think in terms of news, we're kind of getting to the end of what I wanted to say. To quickly come back to what we said last week, of course, we talked about Valkyria Chronicles.
Oh, yes. It comes out soon.
Yes, it's actually been now also, because I think last time we talked about that, it was announced that it would come out on PC, but we didn't know if it was on Steam yet. Well, now, of course, it is.
Yeah.
It comes out next week. You already pre-ordered it, correct?
Yep, yep.
I'm definitely going to play it someday, not immediately though, when it comes out. I don't even think, like, it's a single-player only game, I think. I'll do a Let's Play of it someday, but like I said, I've actually already played the game back then, so I'll definitely get it. It's cheap too, so for that price, it's definitely must-buy. But I got some other projects coming up. Like I said, I'm going to probably do some GTA currently, but I also bought the Lords of the Fallen game, which is a Dark Souls clone made by Europeans, has been getting okay reviews. Like, a lot of reviews that I see are 7 and 8. And they say that it's good, but it's not the excellence that, for example, Dark Souls has. So I have to look at that. But also a game, but I'm probably going to do that at the end of November. I still want to play the Evil Within. But I have so many fucking Let's Plays at the moment right now that I kind of want to complete some first before I actually start into new stuff. I mean, I need to get back into Alien as well. I've been wanting to get back to that game because, you know, so many people were so positive about that game, and I still had my problems with it. But, like I said, it also has some very cool moments, so I'm definitely getting back into that. You still haven't played that game at all, did you?
No, not really. Yeah.
Maybe someday.
I'll get to it eventually.
Yeah. Probably like in the Christmas when like all the November stuff, has rained over, probably by then. So that's pretty much it. So all right, do you have any other news? It's been quite a week.
Oh, new Holocaptor DLC came out for Arma.
Oh, I saw that this morning. What is that about?
Okay, so I actually been messing around, and I'm kind of currently messing around on it. They added new helicopters. There's two new transport choppers. They added slings to them, so you can like pick up vehicles. They actually added all helicopters. They redid the helicopter physics, so now they're more realistic. They're a little bit more touchy, so I don't know if that's realistic or what. But they've definitely revamped them. Like, you can actually, if you lose your engine, you can actually I forget what the term's called. But you can basically flare your landing now, so like you don't drop like a fucking brick out of the sky.
All right, yeah, I know that feeling. Yeah. So does it add, because I think that I read somewhere that it adds in multiplayer games, it adds like new objectives where you actually need to transport troops and stuff, right?
Yeah, something called support. I actually haven't. Can I look at that right now? I don't know what it is, so I'm gonna figure it out. It's called support, and that's all I know.
Mm. Any single player campaign sort of update though?
I don't think so.
All right, so no mission for that. It is one thing that there, because I think they had three like DLC packs, right, announced in the season pass, and I think this is the second one. Is that true? Or is this the first one?
Yeah, I think this is the second one. Yeah, I think it's the second one.
Yeah, okay. Because one thing that I thought was interesting is, I don't know actually how long Arma 3 has now been released. Has it been a year?
Almost. Since it went alpha?
Since it was alpha, okay. So
third DLC is Zeus. I forgot about, if you count Zeus.
Oh yeah, all right. So, because, of course, you know, all of the Arma before this, they all had regular expansions, right? And the expansions just added a new map or several new maps. and I was indeed thinking of what they could actually release with this. I actually don't know. Did you see that the mod, the first version of the mod, I forgot what it was called, like Cosmos or something, where basically you can fly real time from
Oh,
fucking Altus to all the way into fucking space.
yeah. I don't know what's up with that, but
They even made
kind of fun.
like the Earth. They made it like in real size, real life size. It's ridiculous, the thing I saw. I mean, it takes like 10 minutes or something to fly and get to space. It's insane, but the opportunities that it gives you are pretty impressive though. I don't think I'm actually going to make a video of it now because it's still very bare bones currently. But of course, in the future, if they would actually add some Star Wars or some other spaceship mod things, then I'll definitely give it a try. But yeah, so we have the Chopper DLC. I thought that some other DLC would also be announced after the Chopper DLC, but I forgot what it was. It might have actually been some weapons or something.
Yeah, I'm not too sure.
You're checking out that support thing?
Yeah, it looks like it's something to do with helicopters and online. I'm not really too sure.
How does it differ
Yeah,
from the
I'm
Take
not
On
really out
Helicopters game,
of
though? I mean, obviously this is DLC, so it's
They you
much
actually
smaller,
they
but
kind of use the physics from it.
okay, so it is definitely very like tight.
Yeah, so it makes it like more realistic.
Je hebt volgens mij ooit wel eens gehuurd in een videotheek voor de SNES vroeger. Ja. Maar die game weet ik helemaal niet
So,
meer. Dus
what does that
dat
mean
zou
for
liegen
me?
zijn.
Because
Oké,
I
dan
have
weet ik
a
het anders. Het
I
mist heel erg hard buiten vandaag.
could
Ja,
play cards though.
En
Back when they were
moest gestrijden.
released.
Dus dat klopt echt.
Remember they
Gisteren
could
mist het
actually
heel
pay for
erg.
cards?
Ja.
I didn't.
En
But I got
still
played. Ik wil
vehicles will still be like
tot
upgraded and
15
everything,
jaar
but I don't know about
game op de Jeep worden mist.
I don't know about have or like how it's gonna work with the other two helicopters. I don't think you'd be able to use them.
All right. Are they blue four, op four?
Both. There's a one transport chopper for blue four and one for op four. All
right. All right. I guess that is about it. Actually, also pretty bright weekend that was now.
Nou, oké, in ieder geval, ik dacht dat ik een documentaire maakte, was, maar dat is een ding.
Gorillas in de so much for listening.
Even kijken.
I'll see you guys next week.
En dan nummer 4.